We've shown you how to learn simple logic. Now let's explain the Python code. We'll start off with looking at types. You may have seen a previous video where we introduced three types. Numbers are either integers, so they're complete numbers, full numbers, or if they have a decimal place, a fraction, they're floating point numbers called float, and text we call strings. So it's a string. Those are types. If we want to print something on a screen, we can use the print word. And what we want to print, we put in brackets. So whatever message you want, we put the word print and then that message in brackets. So a string, like hello, this is a print statement, is in quotes. We put that in the brackets with print word before it. And that will print, hello, this is a print statement, to the screen. With an integer or a floating point, we don't need the double or single quotes. It's not a string. So for example, number 7, we can just say print 7. We still use the brackets there. So we're looking at a true or false. The computer term for this is a boolean. So true or false, we're going to say true or false equals true. So if we print true or false, the output will be true. So on the screen it will print true. If it's false, when we print it to the screen, it will print false. So we have true or false. That's a boolean. We want to put that in some code that means we've got a choice what we're going to do, and that works in an if statement. So this is our task. We want to print a message if true or false is true, but we don't want to print it if it's false. That's what we're going to try to do. So here's the stages of the code. We're going to break it down to make it simple to understand. Here's our print statement. This will just print message to the screen. So that's the print statement. Now we want an if statement, so we use the word if. Now this is important. We've moved the print message over, and now there's a space before it, which seems a bit strange, but that is called an indentation, and that's very important. So we'll talk about why that happens later, but for now remember the print message has been moved over, so there's a gap before it. We've got our true or false. We know it's either true or false, so that goes after the if word. That's called a condition, and that's going to be either true or false. Finally, we've got a colon. So we've got if, we've got our condition, true or false, we've got a colon, then on another line we've got a space, which is called an indentation, and then we've got our print message. So if you put all this together, if true or false is true, then this code will print message to the screen. It looks at the condition, it's true, so it does what we ask it to do in the print statement. We're saying print message to on the screen, and it does that because it's true. In the other case where it's false, we don't want it to print message, so we're saying that the condition is not true, it's false, so don't do it. So there's no output, there's nothing printed to the screen. When it says output, no output, or message in the previous slide, it's in red just to show you. It doesn't output to the screen in red. It's just so it's easier to see. Okay, so we know the if statement with this true or false. How about if else? So we've got the same code. We've got true or false equals true. We've got the if true or false, and we've got print message. That's all the same. But what we've added here, instead of having if, we've got else then colon, meaning if not the first part, do something different. The same as if not AM, we want PM. So in this example, where true or false is true, it's going to do what we say in the if part, which is print message, and it's not going to do the else part because that's the opposite. So the output would be message. In this other example, where true or false is false, when we don't want to print message in the if part because that's false, and because it's false, we do the else part, so we have new message. We either have message or new message. If it's true, the if part happens, we print message, and if it's false, we do the else part, which is the new message. So that is an if else statement. Okay, I hope you enjoyed the video, and if you haven't already, please subscribe. Thank you, and look forward to the next video. Bye for now.